Hey, what's going on, everybody? Chad Christian here. I'm bringing you a game-changing video. The application that we're going to be talking about today is bettertouchtool. I'm using this with my MacBook Pro with Touch Bar. Now, of course, you can use this with any MacBook, but the nice thing with it, with the Touch Bar version, is you can make nice, quick, short icons just like that on your Touch Bar. So let me go ahead and show you how you do that. So in here in the global setting, I've selected Touch Bar, and you can see that you can change a lot of different things, and we'll go over some of those today. But if you click on Touch Bar, let's say for example a new one that I will add, so click on Add Touch Bar, let's call it a name. I do a lot of screenshots for content creation, so we'll just call this one Screen, and you can name it as long or as short as you want, and that will show up in the Touch Bar down there. So of course the command for screenshot is Command Shift 4. So if I just type that in now, you can now see that that action is in there. So now it has added a screen button, as you can see down there. Now what I'll do is I can change or add an icon to it. So in this case, let's just change the color for it. So if I click on this button here, and there's a wide variety of ways that you can change the colors, but in this case we'll just pick a nice blue. This will be my screenshot. I click save, and there it is. And I'll show you how to use that here in just a second and what those look like. So in this example, let's go ahead and if you look over here, there's select application. The cool thing with this app is you can make it app specific. So in this case, if I want to add anything to Safari, I can click in here. Let's say I want to go to my YouTube channel. So I'll just put in YouTube. If I could type. Now if I go over here into my predefined actions, this is where you can change everything, and there's just a ton of different things that you can do, and you can play around with this. You can have it record different mouse actions. There's just a lot of cool things that you can do here. So in this case, we're going to go into utility actions. I'm going to tell it to open a URL. And what we'll do here is we will get my URL for my YouTube channel. We'll copy that. We'll paste in my YouTube channel there, and I'll click save. Now here's something really cool that you can do too. If you look over here, it says to add icons. So let me show you how you can add an icon. So what we'll do is, see this here? I'll just grab this logo, and we'll use our new screenshot ability that we just made. So if I click on screen, you can now see that my cursor has changed to the screenshot logo. Let's go ahead and screenshot this little play button. So as you heard, that put it there on my desktop. Now, where it says YouTube, what I can do is I can drag this icon over right here to the icon area. So you can now see that this is lit up. And what I do is if I go into my settings, I can tell it to only show the icon. Click save. Now notice it's not on my toolbar right now. Well, that's because it's only triggered once I go into the specific app that I selected over here. So let's go into Safari. And there it is. So now you can see that right there's my YouTube button that we just created. So if I click on that, and there it is. Takes us right to the YouTube page. Now another cool one that I could add is I print a lot. So if I click on Add Touch Bar, and I tell it down here that we're going to print. And of course the command for printing is Command P. So you can see now in the Touch Bar area down there, there's one called Print. So again, I'm going to go into my settings, and let's just change the color for printing. And if I click save, you see how that changed that button automatically? Now if I'm on a web page and I click the print button, there it is. One of the cool other things that I've set up is a button for lock. So if I want, when I walk away from my computer, if I hit the lock button, you can see that now my system locks up. If I want to unlock my system, of course it's going to unlock with my Apple Watch, but or I could then use the Touch ID sensor to unlock my system. Now another one that I have turned on is notifications. So if I want to see my notifications, I can hit the Noti, or I can call it notifications. Just by pressing that button now, everything comes up. I can tell it to use trackpad gestures. So just like the touch bar, we're going to create a new one for trackpads. So if I go over here to trackpads under global, click on add new gesture. Let's tell it what kind of gesture we want. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to use a four finger tap gesture. And in this case, I'm going to tell it to go ahead and mute my system. So now if I use four fingers on my trackpad, you can see that it mutes it. Now if I want to take this one step further, this is how easy it is to add whatever you want. So in this case, let's do the same thing. Let's go four finger gesture. This time let's do a swipe right. We'll go into our keyboard keys and we'll tell it to use volume up. Then I can do the same thing again. If I want to tell it to go volume down, four finger will go swipe left. Go over here, go to your keyboard actions, and we'll go volume down. So now you'll notice that I can control everything by just tapping and swiping. So used in conjunction with other buttons that I've already created, if you look at the play button here, so I've got my music app up. If I just click play, so now I can mute, turn on, off, volume up, volume down. Just that easy. But I could see how programmers could write scripts inside of this. So if you wanted to launch another application, maybe do some terminal scripting. So if you do want to run, you know, ping commands or trace routes, you can look for different things. There's just, it's an unlimited tool for what you can do. So I'd like to see you guys fool around with it. If you come up with any cool combinations or ideas, make sure you comment down below. I would love to see those. And maybe I'll post them on another video. If you want to see additional add-ons or more things you can do with it, let me know in the comments down below. Now, this application is a trial. It's a 45-day trial. If you wish to purchase it, you can donate anywhere from $4.49 all the way up to $50. So that's going to do it for my video today. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up and subscribe. Turn on your notifications, and I'll see you guys on the next video.